throughout the Montgomery libraries, we've heard stories of a small, unidentified reptilian creature. The first reports occurred shortly after we closed due to COVID-19, almost as if this unnatural circumstance created the perfect opportunity for other unnatural occurrences. This program is a legend in the making. It's told through a series of dramatizations, interviews with people who know things, and accounts with people who saw something. For entertainment purposes only, may not be suitable for viewers who believe everything they see on YouTube videos.
It was just your typical day in 2020 when the phone rang. Now that I think about it, still a typical day in 2020.
Yeah, this is Annie.
Hey, yeah, it's Caitlin from Governor Square.
Is it Governor Square now?
You know that video you posted? We've seen the Saurus too.
Okay, yeah, I'll be there, but, We're not calling it that.
Saurus?
No. So we're calling it Thesaurus. I mean, it fits, so I'm not that mad. It's small, it's scaly, it's green, looks kind of like a dinosaur. Thesaurus makes sense. I'm not happy about it. In fact, kind of mad about it. I'm infuriated, disappointed, angry. I'm infuriated, I'm incensed, I'm livid, steamed up, just angry.
Because it was later in the afternoon when I got the phone call from Governor Square, I asked my staff to help me do some research. We didn't really find anything, and it was hard work. In the end, we were left with more questions than answers. Then I asked them to review the security camera footage.
Go there.
Can you believe it? What?
Look how fast he's moving.
Oh, wow. Naya,
look. He's trying to get in the lobby.
With all that I've seen, I'm a believer, I'm a true believer now. There's something out there. But what is it? If you got any information for us, please send it in, now.
So me and my staff have been doing a lot of research trying to figure out what this thing is, and we haven't even narrowed it down. It could be anything. We just know it's small, we know it's some sort of reptile, but it also seems to have some kind of fur on it. There's not enough evidence. We don't know.
My world feels a little turned upside down. As a kid, it's easy to believe in monsters, but when you grow up and become an adult, it just seems less likely, and then all of a sudden, one pops up and you're responsible for figuring out what it is. I found myself getting lost in thought. It's a good thing the drive to Governor Square Library is the perfect road to drive along. Your mind wants to wander.
Saying something about seeing this thing over by the book bench, which we got those last year in January. This one was done by Oscar Trill J. Wheat. Y'all will see that real soon. As you can see, it's kind of busy today, but I did promise to come out here.
Because I'm a wild
and As promised, I'm here to keep you posted.
Governor Square offers Wi-Fi, curbside pickup, and story times posted to their Facebook at 10 in the morning on Tuesday. This location also houses extension and outreach services. They provide outreach service to public libraries, public and private schools in Montgomery County, local nursing homes, and assisted living facilities, and Maxwell Federal Prison Camp. Although all of Montgomery's libraries have been closed since the start of COVID, they do offer calm, scenic places for reflection and outdoor seating. Recently, some branches have offered something just a little more curious.
I went outside to go pick up the books from our book drop, and I saw this strange creature crawling around. I'd never seen anything like it before. It crawled around behind our book bench, but when I went to go real carefully take a look at it, it was gone. I went looking in the library trying to find anything in our books, but I couldn't find anything. I'd never seen anything like it. It had this green, scaly skin and these yellow spikes all over its back and its head and this really nasty-looking beak, and I don't think I'd ever want to be at the receiving end of an attack from that kind of thing. I don't know what it's called. I've started calling it the Saurus. So, if you got any idea what it is, your guess is as good as mine.
It feels like the Saurus owns the place, but I have a half-baked idea of where he may be going next.